Welcome to Trinity Insight, the home of the thinking Christian. And today we're discussing things that Christians really should stop saying. So what are some things that Christians really should stop saying? There are many phrases that have emerged from the church culture that are often used but misunderstood. One example is this: I'll go when it's my time. The idea is that since God has your days numbered, no matter what you do, fate has a destiny for you and you'll die whenever your time comes. Now, Calvinist thoughts on this notwithstanding, God knows when you will die. But most Christians believe that they have the freedom to make genuine choices. So God's knowledge of the day of your death speaks to his foreknowledge, but not necessarily philosophical divine determinism. Otherwise, if you'll go when it's your time, why tell your teenager to buckle up when they get in the car? Why get vaccinated? Why ever go to the doctor at all? And most frightening, why tell anyone not to commit suicide? We do these things, though, because we don't want people to unnecessarily shorten their lives. And we do it because though God knows what the day will be, we can make choices that will lengthen or shorten our lives. Here's another problem phrase: God told me. Now, while we obviously do believe that God speaks to us, sometimes we play fast and loose with our claims to divine revelation. Some people even describe their conversations with God so literally that unless you know already what they're talking about, as a new Christian, you might get very depressed about the fact that you also don't hear from God so verbally and literally. Second, it tends to lead people to think that mystical experiences are more beneficial than hearing from God in the one place we can always trust he will speak, his word. Here's another one: I'll be praying for you. Now, I do this quite regularly, so maybe it's not something Christians need to stop altogether. The problem is that we often say this to show compassion without any real intention of devoting a special time of prayer. We may not even remember that we made this commitment by the time we reach the parking lot. Also, it is often a way of offering to help without actually giving of yourself the very thing that might help, be that time, energy, supplies, or money. Finally, God's got a plan. Now, why would I say we should stop saying this? I mean, after all, he does have a plan, right? Well, we really should stop saying this in certain contexts. After a funeral, one Christian will say to another, "Listen, I know this seems bad, but God's got a plan." Now, while this may be true, it also may be the last thing that a grieving soul needs to hear. In fact, they may start thinking, "Why can't God come up with a plan that doesn't involve my child dying?" Instead, why not simply say, "I'm here for you if I can do anything to help." Oh, and as a bonus, what about the phrase, "bless his heart"? Now, while pronouncing a blessing on someone often seems generous, the way Christians often use the phrase, "bless his or her heart," is not. "Bless his heart" is often a preface to an out-and-out insult, as in, "bless her heart, she's the worst singer in our choir," or "bless his heart, he'll never find a wife with a face like that." It has become a coverall way of getting away with something quite unchristian indeed. I submit to you that these are phrases that we either need to only use at certain times or do away with altogether. Thanks for listening. And for more on this and other topics, visit trinitysem.edu and click on the link to the Trinity Insight blog.